Hello guys, it's been a while. Sorry about that. We've been well busy, which is a good thing, but it has meant that I have somewhat neglected the YouTube side of things, which I'm hoping to put a stop to and really try and nail it this summer, so more to come. Anyway, you know how this works. This is a Twitter talk video. I post a hashtag on Twitter, you send in your questions, and then I reply to them. If they're engaging and wonderful enough for me to warrant doing so. So without further ado, this is a great Twitter name, at Bilbo Bevers has asked, have you ever watched Blackadder? Yes, I've watched Blackadder. In fact, when I was younger than I am now, whilst I was still at school, I got really ill for about a week. My mum had just bought the Blackadder box set. So I literally watched the whole thing in about a week, and it's just amazing. You know, like Hugh Laurie, that's probably where my love for Hugh Laurie started off, and is now extended into watching the entire of House, the entirety of House, rather. And yeah, I love it. I've watched all the series, start to finish. Not for a while though, so I'm going to pick that up soon. At Drop Dead Meg X has asked, what's your idea of a perfect first date? Well, I don't believe in cinemas. It's one thing, because you don't talk. The idea of my perfect first date has always been just going to a bar. I'd say a cool bar. Like music on, rock in the background, not too loud though, so you can talk. There's a few of them in London. And literally just getting fucked. Yeah, like that, you know, just something where you can like really sit down and get to know someone. I find so even like meals sometimes, like whilst they're nice, they're quite a sterile environment. It can be quite, especially when you're first meeting someone, it can be quite awkward to like eat in front of them. So keep it simple. Just have a load of drinks and get to know each other. So at LBert1993 has asked, what made you decide to cover Holding Out for a Hero at Download, in brackets, it was great, thank you. Well, we went through a few ideas and we wanted something, because we were playing quite a big stage at Download, there's a lot of people that wouldn't know who we were, we wanted to, you know, mix it up with a cover, make sure that people had something that they could respond to if they didn't know who on earth we were. And that particular song, because we've done like a slew of sort of 80s, English 80s covers in a rock kind of way. And we just thought it'd be cool to have something that was like a little bit different. Obviously, Bonnie Tyler's a woman. So it suits my vocal range perfectly. And yeah, it was just a cool tune. It's about cool stuff as well. Like, it's kind of like very empowering for women, the song. It's all about like, you know, where have all the good men gone? You know, all these guys are useless. Bring me a real man. So yeah, it was quite fun. So, and it's just a big tune, so why not? At Ketamine Panda is asked, is there something you've done you've ever regretted a lot? Of course, it's like, that's part of life, is it not? We all do stuff we regret all the time. I'm trying to think of particular things. When I was at primary school, I once lost my pants whilst we were swimming. That was pretty embarrassing. I had to go commando for the whole rest of the day, which to me now wouldn't be an issue because I'm kind of older and I care less, but when you're younger, I must have only been about 8. Stuff like that is a big deal. I was like, oh, I've got any pants, what am I going to do? So I regret losing those. There's a load of deeper and darker things. I regret giving some people the time and effort that they didn't necessarily deserve. I think if there's any advice I can give, if you're ever working or, you know, if you're in a friendship, just make sure that you're both getting something out of it. So, yeah, there's plenty of things I regret. So, at, I think it's meant to say fuck authority. It's got like an it, two X's in it. Do you like bubble tea? I love bubble tea. I don't drink it enough. The other guys always go on little excursions, especially when we're in places like Cardiff, and make sure they get a bubble tea. But the times that I've had bubble tea, I've always thoroughly enjoyed it. I like the little tapioca balls you get in the bottom. And you kind of suck them up. But don't suck too hard. Sometimes you can like choke. Yeah. So at Danny's Killjoy is just ask, what's your favourite Paramore song? Still Into You, because I'm a girl and I like the soppy stuff. And it's a great song. Paramore's most recent album is just a great album. They're a great band. I've got a lot of love for them. So keep doing what you're doing, Hayley and co. At Murren FVK, do you watch Orange is the New Black? I did start watching Orange is the New Black. I did like it, but I have not finished the first series yet, so I need to get on that. Classic question at Little Busby, DC or Marvel? It's a difficult one. Marvel has some of the classics. I'm a big Iron Man fan. I know that's probably well mainstream and all that Iron Man. Everyone likes Iron Man. He's really cool. Robert Downey Jr. made him awesome. But then DC has Batman. The Batman film's probably some of the best superhero films that have ever been done, the Chris Nolan ones. So it's difficult. Now, and then on the other side, I've just watched the first series of Daredevil on Netflix and it was amazing. So loving a bit of Daredevil at the moment. How, I don't think you can choose, I'm sorry, I can't answer that question. Ryan Radley, I don't know if I've said this one before, but hopefully not. What is the worst lie you've ever told, and did you ever get found out? I wouldn't say it's not the worst lie. It could be the worst lie. It's one that sticks out the most to me anyway. It was when my little brother and me were in the bathroom. I remember it very vividly. He was in the bath, and I was on the toilet, I think, maybe. Anyway, I picked up a toy that we had at the time, and I threw it. Supposed to be throwing it for him, but missed and hit the bathroom window and cracked it, put this little hole in the bathroom window. And my mum came in, noticed it, and was like, who was that? Got really angry. And in my panic, I went, it was Sam. And he at the time was probably only about 3 or 2 in the bath. And she told him off, and he cried his eyes out. And I felt so guilty. It was awful. It was really awful. And didn't fess up for about 4 years. And then one day I went to my mum in the kitchen. She was like, Mum, you know when Sam broke that window in the bathroom? She was like, oh yeah, I remember that. I was like, that was me. I'm really sorry, it's been eating away at me for years. And she was like, well, that's very disappointing, kid. Obviously, she couldn't be that angry because it happened ages ago. But yeah, it was that was definitely one of the lies that stuck with me. I just remember the guilt. Years eating away at my insides. But anyway, I think that's about all we've got time for in this video. Thank you for sending in your questions. You guys are amazing as always, and I'll do more of these soon. Bye.